So a circuit diagram is given, transistor circuit diagram, so where all the resistors are already given with the VCC also. So we need to find VCE and IC values, and also it is given that, and also it is given that take beta equal to 100, and this condition is specified, IE approximately equal to IC. IE approximately equal to IC. Okay. So in the solution, so finally we need to find what is VCE and what is this IC. Okay. So now in the previous session, while discussing the various notations that we are using in amplifier circuits, so I was telling you the different meanings. Okay. So here first we need to identify what are the given parameters here. VCE, capital V with capital CE. So it represents actually the bias point Q. Well, that is one of the coordinates, one of the coordinates in the operating point. Similarly, this capital IC is nothing but the DC collector current. Okay. So therefore, we have to actually find out the DC biasing voltage VCE and the DC collector current IC. So now in this circuit, you are not doing any amplification because there is no small signal connected. Okay. So therefore, this particular circuit is only restricted to establishing the DC conditions inside the circuit. That's all. Okay. So therefore, the DC conditions are established by VCE and the IC values. Okay. So in order to determine them, we have to go through some set of related equations which are going to relate all the parameters. So now if you refer back to your voltage divider configuration, the most important current relation here is IE equation. Okay, so this will be given by, particularly for this circuit, VBB minus VBE divided by RE plus RB by beta plus 1. So it is better always you list all the equations for a given particular biasing type. Okay, so this is our first equation. Now in this we need to actually first find out what is this VBB parameter, because it is not directly given. What we have is only VCC, that's all. Where is this VBB available in the circuit? Okay, so this is the point where VBB is existing, base voltage. Okay, now in the previous session, while explaining the DC conditions, I was telling you that in order to extract this VBB only, we have different configurations here. This potential divider or voltage divider is one such configuration. Okay, so first we will extract the VBB value from given R1 and R2 resistors, and that VBB is going to further set up our VCE and IC inside the circuit. Okay, and also VBE will be 0.7 volts. So even if it is not mentioned in the problem, you take for the transistor VBE as 0.7 volts. Okay. So now in order to get this emitter current IE, we need to first find VBB. So we have another equation to find this. It is a voltage divider equation. So therefore, VBB is nothing but R2 by R1 plus R2 into VCC. Into VCC. Because you have to first apply this VB to the base of the transistor. Then only collector current can flow, and then only VC is available at the collector terminal. Okay, so we have to first find how much is this value. You can just substitute R2 is 5.6 kilo ohms and R1 is 10 kilo ohms, plus again this is 5.6 kilo ohms into 10 volts. So this is going to give us around 3.59 volts. So it means now the base is given 3.59 volts. Using that base voltage, so now we have to find out how much collector current our circuit is going to generate. Okay. So next we'll write what is this collector current. Now in the circuit it is mentioned that take IE equal to IC. Okay, so therefore now that IE equation itself we can use it for finding the IC. Okay. So therefore now I'll write IC equation is nothing but same as IE equation, that is VBB minus VBE divided by RE plus RB by beta plus 1. So remaining all other values are known, so directly we can find the IC. So now it is 3.59 volts minus VBE is 0.7 volts and this divided by RE is 560 ohms plus RB. RB beta plus 1. So beta plus 1 is beta was 100. Okay, anyway, I'll write beta plus in the next step. Now here is 3.6 kilo ohms. Okay, this is RB. Now it is easy to find RB. RB is nothing but just a parallel combination of R1 and R2. So R1 into R2 by R1 plus R2. So you just substitute 10 into 5.6 by 10 plus 5.6. So that will give you approximately 3.6 kilo ohms. So that you can directly substitute because R1 and R2 are connected in parallel. So therefore now our final current IC will be equal to. So subtract 3.59 minus 0.7. This is going to give us 2.89. This is 5.560 ohms, but here we have 3.6 kilo ohms divided by beta. Beta is 100. Okay, so this beta is 100. 100 plus 1, 101. So solve this, we are going to get approximately 4.8 milliamperes. 4.8 milliamperes. So now this is what is a DC collector current that is flowing because of an applied base voltage of 3.59 volts. So next we have to find out VCE. This is another coordinate. So we'll find VCE. Now the equation of VCE, see what we have at the collector. This is where VCE is available. So this is the RC and this is the applied VC and this is where the DC collector current IC is flowing. So it's a simple KVL equation. So VCE is nothing but VCC minus RC into IC or IC into RC. Okay, minus RE into IE. This is the complete equation because RE is also there. RE is also there through which IE is flowing. IE is flowing. Okay, so we are applying KVL to complete the circuit. In that we are extracting only VCE part. So you can find now VCE is nothing but VCC minus. I'll write again IC minus RE into IC only. The reason is in the problem it is given take IE equal to IC. That's why. So therefore VCE is equal to VCC minus RC plus RE into IC. Okay, so therefore VC is equal to, now substitute 10 volts minus R is 1 kilo ohm, RE is 560 ohms into 4.8 milliamperes. Okay, you can take it as 1.56 kilo ohms total multiplied by 4.8, then VC is going to be around 2.5 volts. 2.5 volts. Okay. So therefore, we have now two coordinate points. Now graphically, what are they actually? you have a curve for some base current IB and there is a DC load line. Now this is the Q point. Now we have determined the two coordinates of the Q point. This axis is VCE axis and this is the IC axis. So here it is 4.8 milliampere and here it is 2.5 volts. Okay. So therefore actually we have determined the coordinates, that is VCE, IC, quadrant point coordinates. They are nothing but 2.5 volts, 4.8 milliamperes. Okay. So this means that prior to amplification, we need to establish these DC conditions inside the circuit. Okay. So now once you apply the small signal later during amplification process, that signal will be superimposed on these two DC levels. Then you are going to get an amplified signal at the collector. So one thing you should observe here, everywhere we have used these uppercase terms only representing all the DC circuit arrangement inside the circuit. Okay. So this is what is the solution of this problem. Okay. So next we have one more example. One circuit diagram is given here. It is again a BJT circuit. So RC is there and VCC is also there. Okay, so this is the RC. Small I C. Here we have this VBE as well as capital VBE is there, and through this we have this IE also and VCC. Now in this circuit shown, okay, it is given that VBE is adjusted. Okay, so it is given that VBE is adjusted to yield a DC collector current, of 1 milliampere, okay. And other conditions are, let VCC is equal to 15 volts and RC is equal to 10 kilo ohms and given beta is 100. Okay. So you have to find, first part is voltage gain. See now, VC by VBE. Okay. And in the second part, what is given is, if this VBE is equal to 0.005 sine omega t, then you have to find VC, capital C of t, and IB of t. Okay. So this is what is a given problem statement. So it is again a BJT amplifier circuit. So VCC, RC, beta, everything is mentioned. Now this is important. This VBE is adjusted to yield a DC collector current of 1 milliampere. Okay. So therefore, now find as a first part voltage gain VC by VBE. See now, in the solution, consider the first part. Voltage gain VC by VBE. So therefore, what is this? VC represents output voltage at the collector divided by VBE is nothing but the input signal it is. See, small v, small b, small e. This represents the small signal. So for an applied small signal, what is the total gain that we are getting from the circuit you have to find. Okay, so therefore here we need to write some of the equations. So first I'll list all the relevant equations. First part, so voltage gain, okay, for such a circuit arrangement, voltage gain VC by VBE. We have an expression for this. What is that expression is? VC can be replaced. Because VB is a small signal, okay, so it has to be kept as it is. So only thing is we can replace it for VC. So to write an equivalent term for VC, we have to go back to the main equation at the collector. So at the collector, okay, how do we represent the total instantaneous voltage? Small v capital C. That is equal to DC voltage minus IC into RC. So this is what is our main equation at the collector current. Okay, so VC is nothing but this DC collector voltage minus this small V small C. Okay, this VC represents what? It is the signal component. So therefore now consider only this. So therefore what is this VC is nothing but simply minus IC into RC. This is important now. So we have to find actually voltage gain using this. That is output voltage because of the small signal divided by input small signal. So therefore, now for IC also we have an equivalent equation. So we know that small I small c, what is this? It is the signal, it is the current flowing because of the small signal. IC is given by capital IC by VT into VBE. This is one of the expressions, okay, with respect to these biasing circuits. So now why we need to replace IC by this equation is because in the circuit it is given, we have adjusted some VB such that already DC collector current of 1 milliampere is going. I mean 1 milliampere is present. Okay, that is IC is 1 milliampere is given. So that's why as IC is available, now we can replace the small IC by this equation. Okay. So therefore, now totally the small VC can be written as minus IC by VT into VBE into RC into RC. So this VC I am going to write in the voltage gain equation. Voltage gain equation. So therefore, voltage gain VC by VB. If this is small v, small c. Okay. That is equal to minus IC by VT into VBE into RC divided by, keep this VB as it is. So, this VBE cancels and we have only minus IC by VT into RC. That's all, because the denominator VB is already cancelled. This is our gain equation. Now we will substitute what are these. So therefore VC by VBE equal to minus IC is 1 milliampere divided by Vt is 25 millivolt. So this is a constant. Everywhere in the problem you can take 25 millivolts, milliampere, this is millivolts, into RC given is 10 kilo ohms, 10 kilo ohms. Okay, so therefore solving this you are going to get minus 400 volt by volt. Okay, so these numericals and all you can substitute the given values, but only thing is how to derive the particular equation. Okay, so you have to clearly observe what gain you have to find out. So we have to find out the output, that is the signal component in the total collector voltage, and this is the small signal input. Okay, so this VC actually represents what? Output voltage due to small signal. So obviously input will be small VBE only. Yeah, so that's why in the previous relation we have taken only the signal component. Okay, so what is this equation actually? VC equal to capital VC minus IC into RC. This gives total collector voltage. Total means what? Both the sum of AC as well as the DC. So this is the DC part, this is the AC part, so this is the signal part. Okay, so now you have to take only this part to find out the gain, because VC acts as a constant thing, that's why. Okay, so therefore that's why we have extracted only this much, IC by RC. So further we have substituted for IC. IC is the thing, but capital IC by VT into RC. Okay, so then you have to follow this method to find out the gain equation. Now this is the first part of the problem. In the next part, what is given is you have to find VC of T and IB of T. So I will discuss how to find this VC of T. That is, in the next part you have to find V capital C of T. You have to find VC of T. Find. Okay. When VBE. When VBE is equal to 0.005 sine omega t volts. So this is what is a small signal that is given as an input. This is the input small signal. So when this is applied, what is this VC of t? See, now small v suffix is capital C, means it is the total collector voltage that we have to find out. So therefore, what is our equation actually? The total collector voltage is actually given by VC of T is equal to capital VC plus small v small c. If you add these two, we are going to get the result. So therefore, this also we don't know. VC is how much, it is not known. So obviously, this is how much, that also we have to calculate. So individually we will calculate these two parts. When you combine these two, add these two, we are going to get the answer for the given question. It is the total instantaneous voltage at the collector. Okay. So therefore, let us first find the first part, that is capital VC part. This is easy to find. So the, first of all, the capital VC is nothing but VCC minus IC into RC. That's all. Okay. So VCC given is 15 volts in the problem, IC was given as 1 milliampere, RC is also given 10 kilo ohms. You can easily find that VC is nothing but 5 volts. Okay, so now the first half is available, this is a DC voltage. Now what remains is we have to find out this collector voltage because of the signal component. Okay, so then we will find out what is this small v small c. Okay, okay, so we will write equation for that. We know that from the previous problem that VC by BBE we have calculated as 400. 400. So this gives that this small BC is nothing but VBE into 400. VBE into 400. So VC is equal to VBE, how much is given in this? 0.005. You take only the magnitude part. That sin omega t, it represents the frequency of the input signal. That's all. Okay, need not worry about that. We consider the magnitude of the signal into, or amplitude of the signal into 400. This is going to give us 2 volts. This is equal to 2 volts. Okay. So, actually what is given is some small signal is given. This signal amplitude is 0.005. Okay. So, as it is a sinusoidal signal, sine omega t is also included. But this is only the amplitude part. We will take only the amplitude because we are concerned with the voltage levels. So, Vc is known. Once Vc is known, okay, so let us find out Ic also, because we know that Vc is nothing but Ic into Rc. So, we will find small Ic. Small Ic is equal to Vc by Rc. So, Vc is 2 volt divided by Ic into Rc. Okay, so Ic will be equal to 10 kilo ohms. Because of this, Ic will be equal to 0.2 milliamperes. 0.2 milliamperes. Therefore, Ic into Rc, Vc, which is nothing but Ic into Rc, will be equal to this 0.2 milliamperes into given collector resistor value 10 kilo ohm. This is equal to 2 volts. Okay, it should be written as 2 into sine omega t volts. Why? Because we are writing for output voltage because of small signal. This is a signal component of the output voltage. That's why 2 sine omega t volts. Omega t volts. Okay. So therefore, now in the previous part we have determined what is capital Vc. Now small Vc is also available. Therefore, the solution is V capital C of t, which was Vc plus small v small c, is equal to now 5 plus 2 sine omega t. 5 plus 2 sine omega t. Okay. So this is what is the solution for the given question. So, there is another part also, IB of t. So, using these relations, try to find what is IB of t. Okay. Now, here, one more simple relation. It is given that a BJT is having beta is equal to 100 and is biased at a DC collector current of 1 milliamperes. So therefore find the values of GM, RE and R pi at the bias points. Okay, so for these parameters, GM, RE, R pi, we have already equations. The problem, it is given beta is equal to 100 and the collector current IC is equal to 1 milliampere. So if you have these two data, you can find easily the parameters. GM is given by IC by VT. Okay, so IC is 1 milliampere by VT is 25 millivolts constant. So this will be equal to 0.04, or this is again equal to 40 milliamperes per volt. This is one relation. And what is RE? RE is nothing but input resistance at the base. This is given by 1 by GM. So 1 by 40 milliampere per volt. This is going to give us 25 ohms. And we have one more relation, R pi. R pi is nothing but beta plus 1 into Re. This is the relation between Re and the R pi. These two resistors are related by beta like this. So beta given is 100 into 1 into Re value is 25 ohms. So this gives us 2.52 kilo ohms. Okay. So for these relations, GM, Re and R pi, you need to refer to input resistance at the base topic. So this example shows how to calculate the resistance as well as the transconductance GM when the transistor parameters are given. So in the next session, we'll take a few more examples. So thank you.